In this illustration, we'll see a situation when there is a rotating sleeve in an L-shaped rod. Here, we can see a bent rod ABC is pivoted freely at point C, about which it rotates at uniform angular speed omega in horizontal plane. And on arm AB, a spring of natural length L and a force constant K is attached at point B. And on its other end, a movable sleeve S is attached, which can smoothly slide on the rod. We are required to find the elongation of a spring when sleeve is in equilibrium on rod. So here we can analyze the situation in the rotating frame of reference. And if we draw the picture again, this is the L-shaped rod. And this is a spring which is attached to a sleeve. And it is rotating about point C at an angular speed omega. So we can see if R is the radius of circle in which the sleeve would be circulating, then it is experiencing an outward centrifugal force m omega square R. And the spring will exert a force onto it which is kx, and the length of a spring can be written as L plus x because L was its natural length. And obviously, due to rotation, a normal reaction would be acting on the sleeve due to contact with the rod in this direction, which will balance the forces on it in rotating frame. So here we can write in rotating a reference frame for equilibrium of a sleeve, we use, here you can write, if this angle is theta, which the radial direction makes with the arm AB of this rod, then we can write m omega square r cos theta is equals to kx, which is the force applied by the spring on a sleeve. Here r cos theta can be written as L plus x. So here we can write m omega square L plus x is equals to kx. Further simplifying, we can directly get the elongation in a spring, that is Lx, which is given as m omega square L by k minus m omega square. That will be the final result of this problem.